Welcome you in the lecture series of Basics of Communication Engineering. It is 30th lecture of this series. In previous lecture, we have discussed about basic principles and block diagram of telephone set, basic operations on transmitter and receiver. Also, we have discussed different steps involved in call progress. In this lecture, I would like to discuss about tones in telephone and necessity of telephone exchange. And the outline of this lecture are network call progress tones, telephone network, side tone and anti-side tone circuit. In the objective of this lecture, you will able to explain the different types of call progress tones, necessity of different types of telephone exchange, and you will also able to explain what is the side tone and why it is necessary in the telephone. So first of all, we will discuss about network call progress tone. This table shows you the summary of the alternating tones that could be generated by the central office switch during the phone call in India. And the first tone is acceptance tone, and it is also known as functional acknowledge tone or positive indication tone and the service activated tone. This tone used to indicate that an exchange has received information from SS line or proposed a request received from an exchange line, such as activation deactivation of line service. It may also indicate that an interrogated service is active, and the audio of this tone you can hear. This is the audio of this tone. On time is 1 second and off time is 4 seconds. This is on time, 1 second, four seconds off time, then on. Now another tone is the busy tone. It is also known as engaged tone. This tone advising that the called number, telephone number, is busy, and the busy tone is a quick period tone, where the on period and the is equal to the off period. So on period and off period both are equal 0.75 seconds, and in India the frequency is 400 hertz, and you can hear the busy tone. It will be like this. So on time and off time are same, 0.75 seconds. And the another tone is the congestion tone. It is also known as fast busy tone and the reorder tone. This tone advising the caller that the groups of the line or switching equipments necessary for the setting up of the call or for the use of a specific service are temporarily engaged. This congestion tone is quick period tone, where the on and off period are equal. So here the on period is 0.25 and off period is also 0.25, and you can hear this the audio of this tone. And this tone in India is also of 400 hertz. So this is the tone, 0.25 seconds on and 0.25 seconds off. Another tone is the dial tone. This tone advises the exchange is ready to receive call information and initiate the user to start the sending call information. And in most countries the dial tone is continuous. In few countries it is a slow period tone, where the on period is shorter than the off period. The tone consists of either a single tone or the combination of up to 3 tones. When a single tone is used, it may be modulated by the lower frequency tone. So here this is 400 hertz is modulated by the 25 hertz frequency. So this is 400 hertz. It is modulated by the lower frequency 25 hertz. And this tone is used in India. And the audio of this tone you can hear. This is a continuous tone. This is dial tone. Now another tone is the special tone. It is also known as Stettler tone, and this tone advises the exchange is ready to receive call information and inviting the user to start sending call information, at the same time reminding the user that special conditions apply to terminate from which the call is being made. And the audio of this tone you can hear, this is also of 400 hertz in India. Now another tone is the holding tone. This tone is used to reassure a calling subscriber who has been placed on hold by the subscriber with exchange. And this the on time is 0.25 second and off time is first time it is 0.25 second. And next time the on time is 0.25 second, but the off time is 3.25 second. And you can hear the audio of this tone. And this tone is of a frequency 400 hertz. You can see initially this is 0.25 on and 0.25 off, but in the next time 0.25 second on and 3.25 second off. So this is the pair of tones. One is of on and off time same, but for the other on and off time are different. This is like you can hear two tones. Now next tone is the intrusion tone. It is also known as busy override warning tone, busy verification tone, and the trunk office tone. This tone advising the participant during a call that the privacy of the conversation has been breached, that is by the intervention of the operator. And you can hear the audio of this tone, and this is also of 400 hertz, and the on time is 0.15 second and off time is 4.85 second. On time and off time. Now another tone is the refusal tone. It is also known as switching tone. This tone advises the subscriber that the request for the service cannot be accepted. It may also indicate that the interrogated service is not active. And the audio of this tone you can hear, this is of 400 hertz in India, and on time 0.25 second and off time is also 0.25 second. Now next tone is the ringing tone. First, that is for local calls, and this is also known as audible ringing tone and ringing back tone. This tone advises the caller that a connection has been made and that a calling signal is being applied to a telephone number or service point. It consists of either a single tone or combination of up to three tones. When a single tone is used, it may be modulated by the lower frequency tone. So here you can see 400 hertz tone is modulated with that with lower frequency 25 hertz, and the on time for this ringing tone is 0.4 second and off time is 0.2 second. And the next time the on time is 0.4 second and off time is 2 seconds. And the audio of this tone you can hear, for the first pair 0.4 second, 0.2 second, and next it is 0.4 and 2 second. And ringing tone second, this is for ISD calls. This is also having the frequency 400 hertz, and this is modulated with the lower frequency 25 hertz. And here the on time is 1 second and off time is 2 second. And the audio of this tone you can hear, this is 1 second and off is 2 second. Now next is the root tone. This is of frequency 400 hertz, and the on time is 0.1 second and off time is 0.9 seconds. It indicates that the route is in progress, and the audio of this tone you can hear 0.1 second on time and 0.9 second off time. Now another tone is the call waiting tone. This is of frequency 400, and the on time is 0.2 second, off time is 0.1 second, and another on time is 0.2 second and off time is 7.5 second. This tone advises the user of the call waiting supplementary service who is engaged on a call that someone is attempting to call this number. The call waiting tone is a slow period tone where the on period is shorter than the off period, and the implementation vary, but practically a single or double beep is sent every few seconds, and the audio of this tone you can hear. Seven point five seconds is the off time. The another case, 0.2 and 0.1. And now we will discuss about telephone networks. A telephone network is a telecommunication network that connects computer, which allows telephone calls between two or more parties, as well as newer features such as internet and fax. The idea was revolutionized in 1920s as more and people purchased telephones and used them to communicate news, ideas and personal information. During 1990s, it was further revolutionized by the advent of the computers and other sophisticated communication devices, and with the use of dial-up internet. There are a number of different telephone networks. One is PSTN, Public Switch Telephone Network. A landline network where the telephones must be directly wired into single telephone exchange. This is known as Public Switch Telephone Network, PSTN. We get a telephone connection from the telephone exchange, that is our local office, which is nothing but a twisted pair of wires, and we get the telephone service at home. So the subscriber's handset is connected to the telephone networks by the twisted pair cables known as the local loop via exchange. The signal on the local loop is analog in nature, having bandwidth from 0 to 4000 hertz in this local loop. A switch in the exchange connects a subscriber to the another subscriber for the dialed number for the duration of the call. And when the user first, this is a user first, when the user first dial the number of the user second, the switch established from point A to point B. The user 2 gets a dial tone. When it is picked up, a link is established and only for a duration of the call. When the call is terminated, that is after the communication is over, the handset is put down at both end or at either end, and the link is disconnected. That's why we call it only for the duration of the call. And another is the wireless network. In wireless network, telephones are mobile and can move around within the coverage area. In this network, there is no cost to process of the introducing cables into a building or a connection between the various equipment's locations. The implementation takes place at the physical layer of the OSI model in the network structure. And the example of the wireless networks are the cell phone networks, wireless local area network, wireless sensor networks, satellite communication and terrestrial microwave network, etc. Now, private branch exchange, PBX. This is a private network where a closed group of telephones are connected primarily to each other, and they use a gateway to reach to the outside world. And this is usually used inside companies and call centers. Each device connected to the PBX, such as a telephone, a fax machine, or a computer modem, is referred to as extension. And another is the Integrated Service Digital Network, ISDN. ISDN is a set of communication standards for the simultaneous digital transmission of voice, video, data, and other network services over the digitalized circuit of the PSTN. In ISDN, there are two types of channels, B and D, data. B channels are used for data, which may include voice, and D channels are intended for the signals and control, but they can also be used for the data. And ISDN has largely been replaced with the digital subscriber line, DSL, and DSL systems for much higher performance. The inner loop of the telephone network is, you can see on your screen, where the different components are there. Local loop, this local loop is connected to the user and is essentially an analog line which has bandwidth 4000 hertz, and that is adequate for the voice communication. So it is a simple twisted pair of wires which is connected to the end office, and the end office is essentially the telephone exchange, and end users are connected to this exchange through the analog lines, that is local loop. And the trunk lines, the end offices exchange are connected usually using the trunk lines to the tandem office, and tandem office is connected to the regional office using the trunk lines, and these regional office and tandem office are also connected to the trunk line, and end office and tandem office are connected to the trunk lines. And on the other side, the telephone user is connected to the end office with the local loop. This is some kind of generic representation of the telephone networks. Here we have shown only few trunk lines. These trunk lines are implemented with the help of high-speed lines. For example, these trunk lines can be implemented by using coaxial cable. It can be implemented using microwave links, optical fiber link, and also by the satellite network. So you may ask why these are implemented not by using twisted pair of wires. The reason is here. The trunk lines are of much higher bandwidth. The voice lines are of only 4 kHz bandwidth. But a number of such channels are combined with the help of multiplexing technique to have much higher data rate. And these are connected through the trunk lines. That's why we will require coaxial cable if the distance is not large, or we use microwave link or optical fiber or satellite network when the distance is much higher. Now we will discuss about side tone. The signal produced by the transmitter is carried by the loop current variations of the receiver of a called party. So a small amount of transmitted signal is fed back into the talker's receiver, and this is known as the side tone. Side tone is necessary so that the person can hear her or his voice from the receiver to determine how loudly to speak. The side tone must be at proper level, because too much side tone will cause the person to speak too soft for good reception by the called party. Conversely, too little side tone will cause the person to speak so loudly that it may sound like yell at the receiving end. And so when we speak in front of the telephone transmitter, we hear own voice in the receiver as a feedback. With the help of this feedback, we are able to adjust the volume of our voice according to different situation. When the level of this feedback is high, we lower our voice, and when it is low, we speak louder. This feedback voice is known as side tone. Side tone may be defined as the reproduction of the sound in the receiver picked up from the associated transmitter, or the amount of voice power coupled from the transmitter to the receiver of the same telephone. Too much side tone and complete absence of it is undesirable. The desirable amount of is that which we have in our daily free air conversation with each other across the table. Now, anti-side tone circuit. To control the level of side tone to the desirable amount, anti-side tone induction coil ASTIC is used in the subscriber telephone set. The anti-side tone induction coil serves the following: control the level of the side tone to the desirable amount, ensure that no DC current flow through the receiver, and matching between the impedance of the transmitter and receiver with that of line. And this is a simple circuit arrangement for the reduction of the side tone, as you can see on your screen. In this, transmitter is transmitting if ZB, or if there is ZB is equal to ZL, impedance at this side will be equal to the impedance on the load side, and L1 is equal to L2, then the transmitter current divided equally in L1 and L2. This means I1 and I2 will be same. And here the magnetic field produced by the two winding will be equal and opposite, so they cancel each other's effect, so no EMF is induced in L3, and a side tone is completely eliminated. Practically L1 and L2 are not exactly equal, so some EMF is induced in L3, and so the receiver receives a portion of the transmitted current. And in receiving end, receiving current passes through the L1 and L2. The magnetic field produced are in same direction and reinforced each other's effect, and an EMF is induced in the receiver circuit and current flow through the receiver. So the current flowing in L1 and L2, this is same in magnitude and same in direction. So there is current introduced in the L3, and there will be a current in the receiving circuit. So the anti-side tone circuit is modified. So here, this is the modified anti-side tone circuit here. To make practical, in this modified circuit, three windings L1, L2, L3 are magnetically coupled, and L1 and L2 are not equal, and so an EMF is induced in L3 from the transmitter. The value of R across which the receiver is connected is such that the voltage drop across it is equal and opposite to the EMF induced in L3. This results in much reduction in the side tone in the receiver. So with using this modified circuit using R, we can have much reduced side tone in the receiver. And this is the end of this lecture. Here we have discussed about different types of call progress tones and necessity, and different types of telephone networks. Also, we have discussed about the side tone in the telephone. And this was 30th lecture of the lecture series of Basics of Communication Engineering. In the next lecture, we will discuss about pulse dialing and dual tone multi-frequency DTMF dialing. Till then, thanks for listening this lecture. Thank you.